हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो दिस इज द थर्ड लेक्चर ऑफ कैपेसिटेंस एंड कैपेसिटर एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस द पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर. ओके, दैट मींस टू पैरेलल प्लेट कंडक्टर्स. ओके, दे आर सेपरेटेड बाय सम डिस्टेंस एंड ईच पैरेलल प्लेट्स हैज सम एरिया ए. ओके, सो वी विल डिराइव द कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ दिस कैपेसिटर. ओके, दिस इज अ कैपेसिटर, सो वी विल डिराइव द कैपेसिटेंस फॉर्मूला ऑफ दिस कैपेसिटर. Okay, and then you will automatically understand that capacitance depends on surrounding medium, capacitance depends on shape and size. Okay, that thing I had told in the first lecture of this topic, okay, of this chapter. So you will understand it here, how capacitance depends on shape and size, how capacitance depends on surrounding medium. Okay, so start it. So suppose on this plate, the charge is plus Q. Okay, and it is positively charged and the other plate will be negatively charged and same amount of charge, that is minus Q. Okay, area is A, area of this plate is A, area of this plate is also A. Okay, so what will be the surface charge density? Sigma surface charge density will be charge by area. Okay, on this plate it will be plus Q plus sigma, on this plate it will be minus sigma. Okay, clear? And the separation, I told that this separation is very small. Okay, separation is very small and electric field in this region between the two plates will be uniform. Okay, uniform electric field. And as it is positively charged and negatively charged, so there will be a potential difference between the two plates. Okay, there is a potential difference between the two plates. Separation is D. This is uniform electric field region. So what will be the relation between the potential difference, separation D and E? The relation will be E equal to V by D. We will use these two concepts here because this distance is very small. Okay, so this region will be uniform electric field region. Clear? So here first we will find the electric field in between two points. Okay, anywhere in between the two plates, we will find the electric field intensity. Okay, and this point, the distance of this point from any one plate is very small compared to its area. Okay, so for this reason, we can use that formula of electric field intensity, which we had already discussed in Gauss theorem. Okay, what is that? The electric field intensity due to uniformly charged infinite plane sheet. Okay, uniformly charged infinite plane sheet. We will use that formula here. Okay, so at this point, due to this plus charge, electric field will act in this direction. Okay, electric field means what? The force on unit positive charge. If you keep here unit positive charge, then this is positively charged and this is positively charged plate. So they will repel each other. Okay, so force will act in this direction. And its value will be electric field intensity due to plus charge will be what? Sigma by 2 epsilon 0. This is the formula. This is the formula that we had discussed in Gauss theorem. Okay, electric field intensity due to uniformly charged infinite plane sheet. And now come to this negative plate. Okay. Due to this negative plate, the force acting on this unit positive charge will be in the same direction, right? Will be in the same direction. So E minus will also be sigma by 2 epsilon 0. Okay? And I had told that do not put plus minus sign in the formula of electric field intensity because plus minus sign only tells about the direction of the intensity at a particular point. Okay? So here we are seeing that the direction is acting in the same, okay, in the same direction. So total electric field at any point in between the two plates, electric field will be E equal to sum of this because they are acting in the same direction. So sigma by 2 epsilon 0 plus sigma by 2 epsilon 0. So it will be sigma by epsilon 0. Okay, initially I am taking this region between two plates is free space means epsilon 0. Okay, so this will be the electric field intensity in between the two plates. Electric field will act in this direction, okay, positive to negative, we all know this thing. Okay, Now we have to find the potential difference between two plates. So electric field we know, separation we know, and we know that this field, this region is uniform electric field region. Okay, so we will use this formula and we will find the potential difference between two plates. So potential difference between two plates V will be what? E into D. Okay, E into D. Okay, so E is this. So sigma D by epsilon 0. Now put the value of sigma, that is Q by A. So Q D by epsilon 0 A. Clear? Clear. Now capacitance, what is the formula of capacitance? Q C equal to Q by V. Okay, C equal to Q by V. So from this relation we will find Q by V. Okay, so first do the cross multiplication. So V epsilon 0 A equal to Q into D. Clear? Clear. Now Q by V, so take V in this side. So Q by V will be epsilon 0 A by D. Clear? Now Q by V is what? Q by V is C. C is equal to epsilon 0 A by D. Okay? Now look at this formula. This is the expression. This is the expression of capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor. If there is nothing in between two plates, there is free space, then this is the formula. Now look at this formula. Then you will automatically understand the points on which the capacitance of a capacitor depends on and the points on which capacitance does not depend. So capacitance does not depend on the charge. There is no charge. Okay, charge density, nothing is there in this formula. So capacitance does not depend on Q. Okay, capacitance does not depend on this potential difference between the two plates. Okay, and capacitance depends on this area, that means shape and size. Area and D, these two things tells about shape and size. Okay, and this epsilon 0 tells about the surrounding medium. Okay, surrounding medium. So capacitance depends on shape and size of the capacitor and the surrounding medium. Okay, as there is free space, so it is epsilon 0. Clear? This derivation is very, very important for your board exam. Okay, now I am erasing this and writing it here. So E equal to sigma by epsilon 0, that I am writing here, and C equal to that. We need these two things. So C, capacitance equal to epsilon 0 A by D. Okay, and the electric field between two plates is sigma by epsilon 0. Okay, clear? Clear. These two are very, very important thing. Now if the medium is not free space, if there is any medium, okay, and suppose the dielectric constant of that medium is K, okay, suppose the dielectric constant, of medium between two plates, is K, where K is always greater than 1. Okay, you know this thing, K is always greater than 1. Then C will be, then suppose write C prime. C prime will be K epsilon 0 A by D. Okay, then this is the formula. In general, formula is this. Okay, and if there is any medium, okay, except free space, then capacitance is always greater than this capacitance. Okay, capacitance is always greater than C. Okay, so whenever there is a medium between two plates, then capacitance will increase. Clear? Capacitance will increase. Clear? Okay, now come to that energy derivation we have done. Okay, so energy stored in a capacitor, that is half CV square, Q square by 2C, half Q into V. Okay, three formulas. So in this region, between the two plates, in this region, the energy is stored. Okay, whatever the energy the, that we had derived that energy will be stored in this region, in between the two plates. Okay. So I am erasing this thing. So in general, the formula is C equal to K epsilon 0 E by T, where K is the dielectric constant of the medium. If it is free space, then K equal to 1. Okay, simple. Okay. Now, what will be the energy stored? So, energy stored is half C V square. Okay, this is the total energy stored in this region. Okay, now we will calculate the energy density. Okay, energy density. So, energy density. Energy density written by small u. Energy density means total energy. Write it energy, otherwise you will be confused. En. So, total energy by its volume. Okay, total energy means half C V square by its volume means what? Area is this and this is the distance. So, volume will be area into D. Okay. Now, put the value of C. C is epsilon 0 A by D. Only write this is free space suppose. Then epsilon 0 A by D. Okay, this is C. Then V square by A into D. Clear. Now A cancel out. Okay. Now I am writing it. Half epsilon 0 V by D. Whole square. This is V square and denominator it is D square. So you can write it as V by D whole square. Now V by D equal to what? V by D is electric field intensity in between the plates. So it will be half epsilon 0 E square. This is the energy density U. So U equal to half epsilon 0 E square. Energy density U equal to half epsilon 0 E square. Remember this formula. This is also very very important formula. This is energy density. Unit will be what? Joule per meter cube. Energy per unit volume. Joule per meter cube will be its unit. Okay. So energy density I am also writing it here. Okay. Clear everyone? Clear. I am also writing it there. Half epsilon 0 E square. So energy density U equal to half epsilon 0 E square. Okay. E is the electric field intensity. Okay. Now come to another point. That is the force between two plates. As it is positively charged, it is negatively charged. So they will attract them. Right. Positive negative charge, they will attract them. Okay. So what will be the force between the two plates? So force between two plates. Clear? So for finding force, as it is uniform electric field region, so we'll find the electric field intensity first due to this positively charged plate. Okay? So electric field intensity due to this positively charged plate, it will be what? I'm writing only its magnitude. So it will be what? That is sigma by 2 epsilon 0. Okay. Sigma by 2 epsilon 0. Now sigma means Q by A. So Q by 2 epsilon 0 A. This is the electric field due to this positively charged plate. Okay. In the place of this negatively charged plate. Okay. It is uniform electric field region. So it will be constant everywhere. Clear. Now force. Force on negative charge minus Q. So force will be Q into electric field. Okay. It will be attractive force because one is positive, another is negative. Force will act in this direction. Right. Force will act in this direction. So do not put the negative sign. Negative sign only tells about that it is attractive force. Okay. If I write it here negative minus Q into E plus, then you will get minus Q square by 2 epsilon 0 A. This negative sign tells about that it is attractive force. Okay. it is attractive force. Okay, so F force will be, if we take the magnitude only, then Q square by 2 epsilon 0 A. Okay, so only the magnitude will be F equal to Q square by 2 epsilon 0 A. Okay, this is the force between two plates, okay, or parallel plate capacitor. Now come to pressure, force per unit area, okay, pressure, and here that pressure is known as electrostatic pressure. So electrostatic pressure, okay, written by small p equal to force per unit area, okay, force per unit area. So here force Q square by 2 epsilon 0 A per unit area. One more A will be in the denominator, so A square. Clear. Now Q by A. Now we will do some derivation. We'll make it shorter and simpler. Okay. So Q you can use that thing. Okay. Or Q by A you can put Q by A means sigma. Okay. So 1 by 2 epsilon 0 Q by A, that means sigma square. Okay, sigma square. Clear. Now we will convert this thing using electric field. Okay, electric field between two plates. So what is the formula of electric field? That is sigma by epsilon 0. Okay, now in place of sigma we will write E into epsilon 0. Right, sigma equal to E into epsilon 0. So in place of sigma I am writing epsilon 0 E whole square. Clear? Epsilon 0 E whole square. So it will be epsilon 0 square into E square. Okay. Now 1 epsilon 0 cancelled out. So electrostatic pressure becomes half epsilon 0 E square. So this is electrostatic pressure. Okay, this is electrostatic pressure, that means force between the two plates per unit area. Okay, so look at this formula, P equal to half epsilon 0 E square, and again energy density equal to half epsilon 0 E square. So they are numerically equal. Okay, I am erasing this part and writing there that formula. So electrostatic pressure on any plate will be what? Pressure on any plate will be P equal to half epsilon 0 E square. Okay, so these two quantities are basically equal. Okay, numerically they are equal. But this is energy density, that means energy stored in the capacitor per unit volume. And this is pressure, that means force on any one plate due to the other per unit area. Okay, clear. Now, I have found the electric field intensity in this region between the two plates. What will be the electric field intensity in this region? Suppose this is first region and this is suppose second region. What will be the electric field intensity in the region 1 and 2? What will be the electric field intensity? So, in region 1. In region 1. Okay. In region 1, if we take a point which is very near to these plates or to this capacitor, okay, then electric field intensity at this point due to this plus charge will act in this direction, and due to this plate will act in this direction. Now they are oppositely directed, okay, but their values are same because the formula is this: E plus will be sigma by 2 epsilon 0 and E minus will be sigma by 2 epsilon 0. Now they are oppositely directed. So total electric field will be sigma by 2 epsilon 0 minus sigma by 2 epsilon 0. So it will be 0. Okay. In region 1, electric field is 0. Okay. Now in region 2, in region 2, okay, take any point, suppose this is the point, then due to this plus charge, positively charged plate, the electric field intensity will act in this direction, and due to this negatively charged plate, electrical intensity will act in this direction. Again, they are oppositely directed. So again, in the region 2, the electric field intensity will be sigma by 2 epsilon 0 minus sigma by 2 epsilon 0, that is 0. Okay, so electric field intensity is there only in between the plates. Okay, outside the capacitor there is no electric field intensity. Okay, in this region 0, in this region also 0. Clear this concept. Okay, now I will discuss two numericals related to these things. Okay, C, E, U, P, these things. Okay, I am raising. Okay, so this is the first numerical. For a parallel plate capacitor, plate area is given, that is 600 centimeter square. Plate separation D is given 2 millimeter. Potential across the plate is given, that is 200 volt. We have to calculate the magnitude of uniform electric field between the plates and the charge density sigma on any plate. Okay, so how will you do? These two questions are the application of simple formula. So uniform electric field, what are the given quantities? A, B, V. And we have to find first the electric field intensity in between the plates. What is the formula? That is the simple formula. E is equal to V by D. Simple formula. Just put the values. Okay. That is 200 volt by, here it is 2 millimeter. So convert this. 2 millimeter means convert it into SI system. That is 10 to the power minus 3 meter. So 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. Clear? Now 200. It will be 100. That means 10 to the power 2. And here 10 to the power minus 3 goes up. 10 to the power 3. So it will be 10 to the power 5 volt per meter. Clear? Very easy. Simple formula. Now second one. The charge density sigma on any plane. Charge density. So now we know area, distance or separation, potential and electric field. So what will be the formula to find the sigma? There is a direct formula. Okay, there is a direct formula. What is the formula? That formula of electric field intensity, that is E equal to sigma by epsilon 0. Direct formula. So we will use that. E equal to sigma by epsilon 0 or sigma equal to epsilon 0 E. So epsilon 0, value of epsilon 0, you all know that is 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 12 in SI system into E means 10 to the power 5. Okay, what will be its unit? This is sigma, charge density, that means coulomb per meter square. Okay, all are in SI system, so it will be coulomb per meter square. So it will be 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb meter minus 2. Clear? Very easy problem. Just the application of the formulas. Okay? No complications is there. So this is our first problem. Now second problem. I am erasing this. So this is our second problem. Potential difference between two plates. It is given. Area is given. Separation between the two plates is given. If the medium between plates has dielectric constant 3.5, then find potential difference for the same charge. Okay, so this is the first case, okay, for the capacitor in which the medium between the two plates is free space. Okay, so initially the medium between these two plates is free space. This is free space initially. Okay. So, due to this potential difference, there will be some charge, okay? Some charge will be accumulated on these two plates, okay? So, what will be the charge? So, suppose Q1, initial charge. Q1 is what? Q1 is Q equal to Cv. So, C, initial potential, V1. So, C will be epsilon 0 A by D, because this space is free space, okay? There is no dielectric medium, so K equal to 1. And V is 500. Okay, this amount of coulomb. Okay, now the space between two plates is 3.5. Okay, now there is a dielectric medium and here k equal to 3.5, k equal to 3.5, okay, and charge is, what was the initial charge, suppose plus q minus q, charge is same, okay, that means I have disconnected that battery, okay, this battery, I have disconnected that battery, so charge will be same, okay, so this is the question for the same charge, so charge will be same, so I am taking it initially q2 equal to c v2, okay, c prime v2, now c prime will be what, there is a medium, so k epsilon 0 a by d into v2, we don't know, coulomb, okay, now according to the question q1 equal to q2, okay, q1 equal to q2, so q1 equal to q2, okay, so equate them epsilon 0 a by d into 500, epsilon 0 a by d into 500 equal to k epsilon 0 a by d into v2, k epsilon 0 a by d into v2, okay, epsilon 0 a by d, epsilon 0 a by d cancel out, so k v2 equal to 500, so we have to find the potential difference, that means 500 by k, okay, k is how much, 3.5, so put here 500 by 3.5, okay, this much volt, what will be its value, so v2 will be 500 into 10 by 35, okay, 7, 2, that means 1000 by 7, so it will be 7, 1 just 7, 4, 2.9, almost equal to 9 volt, okay, 742.9 volt, okay, this type of numerical is also very very important, okay, means initially that capacitor is charged, okay, after that the battery is removed, okay, then in between these two plates some another medium is placed in between the two plates, okay, so what happens in this case, charges will remain same as battery is removed, so charges will remain same, okay, so the potential will decrease or increase, whatever, okay, so here potential is decreasing, this is the final potential, clear, so this is our topic, parallel plate capacitor, okay, and two numericals, okay, in the next class we will see spherical capacitors, clear.